And thank you for joining us. Wake up, everyone. This is the morning edition. It's Tuesday, August the 13th. Thank goodness it isn't a Friday. I'm Carrie Robertson, along with Gene Wheatley and meteorologist Paul Bouchereau. Paul is filling in for Nelson Robinson this week. Nelson is filling in for who?
For Gary. It's the vacation rotation.
That's the way it is in August, isn't it?
Yes, and, you know, everybody has to take a chance at...
Bread, I can't remember what else is in it. And some other stuff. Sheila Alexander's with us this morning from the Oklahoma Wheat Commission.
Yes, you were talking very highly of her the other day, saying that she always brings on some great recipes.
Yeah, and some good healthful recipes. We use good old Oklahoma wheat, hard red winter wheat.
If you've lived in Oklahoma for any length at all, everyone knows Danny Williams. He's one of the best known radio and television personalities from his days on the radio, from 3D Danny, and of course Danny's Day, which I hosted with him for 4.5 years. He's going to be with us here. He's still on the air, but has exchanged the camera for the microphone on his show at KE. As will Sissy Tubb, an Aryan parent who's volunteering to provide a host home for those French students. Also, a look at the sports and the latest on that crash of a Japanese airliner. So stay with us on the morning edition. We'll be right back.
Five minutes after the hour of 6 o'clock, it's a Tuesday morning. Delighted to have you with us here on the morning edition. And I tell you what, Mr. Bouchereau, it sprinkled just a little bit on me as I came in.
In Lincoln County? You've got to be kidding.
Well, no, as I came into Oklahoma County. Wasn't doing anything in Lincoln County
yet. That's more like it, because it just doesn't rain at your ranch. But there's a good chance you may get some sprinkles today. In fact, right now, across Oklahoma, it's a weird kind of day because we've got a lot of clouds across the northwest, clear skies down the southeast, and it's fairly warm, especially in sections of southeastern Oklahoma. Right now in Oklahoma City, it's a spirit of 76. Low this morning, 76. Right now it's 76. 76 on the humidity, and the pressure, 29.96 and holding steady. Onto the weather, the radar, we have a lot of rain, especially in western sections of Oklahoma, from Kiowa County through Blaine County and up toward Grant and Alfalfa County. The heavier showers are in that dark blue that you see there. And right there's that cloud coverage. You see the southeastern half of the state all clear, northwestern half of the state all cloudy. With chances of rain right along that frontal zone will be 80% to 60% chances of rain.
Like I said, I got some this morning, so I know it's on the way.
Good.
Thank you, Paul. Let's go to Carrie with the news.
At 6:07, here's the news. Japanese officials now say there are only 4 survivors of the Japan Airlines jet that crashed yesterday. There were 5 in investigation into the crash and the search for more survivors a little later on the CBS Morning News. Authorities near Cushing are investigating an apparent double homicide. The bodies of 2 people were discovered late last night. Police say they are questioning a possible suspect in the death of an 8-year-old Oklahoma City boy. No charges have been filed yet, though. Officials have
been... The top story in Farm News this morning is in Chandler. The U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, that's HUD, says that Chandler, Oklahoma, has received preliminary approval on its application for a grant to help build a dairy products processing plant that will create some 298 permanent jobs, comprising about 1/2 of all bank failures nationwide. A comparison with last year is not available since the federal...
Oh, play me some mountain music like Grandma and Grandpa used to play. Then I'll float on down the river.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Morning Edition. It is 6:15, August the 13th, and I understand we need our umbrella today.
Yes. We were talking about country music just a few moments ago. One that comes to mind, B.J. Thomas, Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head.
Good
song. That's what it's doing right now in northwestern Oklahoma. It looks like there's a pretty good chance for a motor. Right now, we have a low so far this morning of 76. Our current temperature is 76. Humidity, also 76 on the percentage side. And the pressure, 29.96. And we do have some light showers to some thunder showers, mainly in western Oklahoma for Ouachita and Custer County. The heavier showers going on right now in the Sentinel area, also just to the west of Thomas. They extend through Blaine County. The heavier rains right now, also in Grant and Alfalfa County, just to the southeast of Cherokee. Also some heavier rains up near Medford. Right now, the thunder showers moving very quickly to the northeast at about 30 miles per hour. The line is moving very slowly to the east, and so it looks like it won't make its way, or the main part of the line won't make its way into Oklahoma City, at least until later this morning into this afternoon. We've had some showers around earlier this morning in Oklahoma City down toward Moore and Norman, but those have been insignificant compared to the showers out toward our west. We have a slight risk for some severe weather, and that'll be later on this morning onto the weather computer, and it's mainly across northern Oklahoma, and that'll continue right on through this afternoon and into tonight. Temperature-wise, 63 out at Guymon, mostly cloudy skies, fair skies down at Altus for the warmest, and for the most part, everybody else in the low 80s to upper 70s, 76 here in the city, 74 at both Ponca City and at Enid up at the Tulsa. They're having 81 degrees, and to our south, 80 out at Ardmore. Here's a satellite movie, Luke. You can see the cloudiness across Oklahoma yesterday afternoon. Watch the moisture just pile into Oklahoma. Out of Texas is coming up the Rio Grande Valley from those southeasterly winds that have been quite brisk, and already we're getting the showers and thundershower activity. And then across the north, we have some very cool rains. Temperatures this morning have been into the 40s and 50s across Montana and North Dakota. We have a tropical depression that's about to move into the Gulf of Mexico. Can't get any of the reconnaissance planes down there because it's moving through Cuban airspace, and Fidel Castro really does not like our planes flying around down there. For the most part, this is where it's located, 160 miles west-southwest of Havana. Max winds right now up about 5 miles per hour to about 35 miles per hour. Movement is northwest at about 12 miles per hour, and that will put it into the eastern Gulf of Mexico later on this afternoon. Looks like it will turn into a tropical storm this afternoon and maybe into a hurricane by tomorrow. There's a current map. Cool front moving through Oklahoma very, very slowly. In fact, most of the motion is now to the northeast. Looks like this cool front will go stationary later on this afternoon, continue to touch off the thunderstorm activity, mainly because of good upper levels disturbances that are moving through the state and a lot of moisture. It's going to be a very humid day for Oklahoma. There's a national radar. Showers up in Montana and Wyoming. Also some heavier showers across Oklahoma. Even some thunderstorms going on in southern sections of Michigan, for the most part out to the west, all clear. Here's what the forecast map should look like. So that front will begin to go stationary across northern Oklahoma. Good chance, anywhere from 40 to 80% chance of rain here in Oklahoma. Temperature-wise, some 100s in the sunshine across much of northern Texas and southern sections of Oklahoma. Basically, everybody south of the front will see 90s. North of the front will see 80s. By Wednesday, again, a good chance of rain, especially in northern Oklahoma, southern Kansas, and into southwestern Missouri. Temperatures are down a little bit more. 90s and mostly 80s across the state thanks to the cloud cover and shower activity we're expecting across the entire state. Here's that five-day forecast. So we have about anywhere from a 40 to 50% chance of rain right on through Thursday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. 91 for today thanks to the cloud cover and showers for tomorrow, 88 and 90 for Thursday. Here's that forecast for the entire state of Oklahoma. We'll be looking for mostly cloudy to partly cloudy skies, showers and a few thunderstorms across the state. Southeast winds to 20, 88 to 101 for today's highs. For tonight, mostly cloudy and mild, scattered thunderstorms across the state. Southeast winds to 15, lows 60 to 75. Then for Wednesday, mostly cloudy and hot. We'll have showers and a few thunder showers around. Southeast winds to 20, highs 84 to 95. For Oklahoma City, mostly cloudy and a chance of rain for today, high of 91. Tonight, 70. Tomorrow, 88 for the high and a chance of thunderstorm really right on through Thursday. So this has been a strange summer. Very, very good chances of rain for the most part for the rest of the week.
So take your umbrellas wherever you go.
Absolutely. Thank you, Paul. All right,
thank you, Paul. Well, next on the Morning Edition, Sheila Alexander will be joining us with a good recipe with bran in it.
And a little later on this hour, a chat with Danny Williams, live from the studios of KEBC. And also, Colleen Wallenbrock and Sissy Tubb with the Nacelle Cultural Exchange will join us. It's about 6:20. We'll be right back on the Morning Edition.
Not all tires come with a warranty.
Warranty.
Weekdays at 9 a.m. only on TV9.
Minutes after the hour of 6 o'clock on a Tuesday, and you're right here on the Morning Edition. And I'll tell you what, nothing is in the news more today than fiber. We hear about it all the time, especially with President Reagan's operation and everything like that. She made it herself.
That's right. That's
beautiful.
Right. You've been out of the sewing world for about 2 years and finally get back into
it. That is great. I like the crocheting around the top. That is gorgeous.
Thank you.
We're talking about fiber this morning.
That's right. As you mentioned, it's very much in the news. People are concerned about it, especially with the incidence of cancer that President Reagan has had. And fiber is kind of an unsung hero. In the past few years, fiber hadn't been given the credit that it deserves in so many instances. It is a very effective treatment for diabetics. The higher some people that we've hit a bottom low, and we're saying how much lower can it go? You know, farmers just cannot stand it. But one of the problems that we're facing is that with Congress in recess, no decisions have been made on the farm bill, our foreign customers are standing back and saying, hey, with this new farm bill, maybe we'll get lower prices, so we just aren't going to buy. And they're staying out of the export market.
So what we're doing is waiting for Congress.
Well, in the meantime, we're working with feedlots, trying to push that wheat feeding. We can't wait on Congress. We've got to continue to do some work and work in the domestic market also.
Okay. Eat more wheat.
That's right.
Thank you, Sheila. Appreciate
Thank
it a
you,
bunch.
Jean.
You're delighted to have you here. Well, we prepared some good news just for Sheila this morning. Wheat prices at Oklahoma elevators went up 2 to 3 cents yesterday, with the Gulf bid at $3.31 a bushel. Let's check cash.
Trivia buffs, here's a game show just for you. Weekday afternoons at 4:30, it's Jeopardy. Play the game as Alex Trebek gives you the answer, and you come up with the correct Jeopardy question. The stakes are high, and so is the excitement. Watch as contestants compete for thousands of dollars in cash. It's fun and informative. Take your chances with some tantalizing trivia. Weekday afternoons at 4:30, right here on TV9.
It's 6:30, and in the weather, we're talking a little bit of rain, a little bit of thunder boomers.
Yes, in the weather, it's really 11:30.
Is it really?
It would go by Greenwich Mean Time.
Oh.
But we will have, even at 11:30 this afternoon, whether it's 11:30 now or 11:30 CDT, we will have some showers. Wind gusts going on in the state of Oklahoma. Onto the weather computer, we do have a slight risk for some severe weather.
Well, Kerry has the news, and OG&E is asking for more money, right, Kerry?
Right, Gene. The hearing on an OG&E request for more money is expected to continue the rest of this week. The company is asking for a $127.8 million rate hike, which would add about 18% to your monthly electric bill. Commercial and industrial consumers would be hit for 13.8%. The case went before the Corporation Commission Monday. Snyder will tell us all about it. It's about 6:34. We'll be right back.
If you've been shopping for new living room furniture, come to Mathis Brothers and get the Bassett Advantage. These Advantage sofas by Bassett are only available at Mathis Brothers and priced well under the...
It's the spirit of Oklahoma. It's the spirit of Oklahoma. TV9.
These days, he's keeping everybody country. Danny Williams may be best known for his 17 years on the television talk and variety show Danny's Day, also as 3D Danny. Danny's Day ran here in Oklahoma City for those 17 years, and although he may be heard more than seen right now, he's enjoying life on the morning show at KEBC. You know, I had the great pleasure of working with this talented man for 4.5 years on Danny's Day, so this is kind of a reunion for me as Danny joins us live this morning. Hello, Danny.
Raining in the Oklahoma City area. Hello, Kerry. We're on the radio and we're on TV both at the same time this morning. It's nice to be on your show on Channel 9, Kerry Robertson.
Well, thank you, Danny. What's the weather like?
The weather like today? Well, as I came through town, it was raining in downtown Oklahoma City, and here on the south part of town at 50th and South Shields, where KABC is, it was raining a little bit. It did rain some overnight. How are you doing? I've been seeing your show, and you look terrific.
Thank you so much. It's so great to be back on TV. I didn't know you cleaned up that good for the morning show. Do you always dress up like that?
You folks probably on radio cannot hear what Kerry just said, so I guess I'll have to extrapolate here. I don't know whether that's a proper term or not, but she didn't know I cleaned up this good for the radio. I'll tell you what, I'm going to talk to you, Kerry, just a moment, but first of all, I got to do a little contest, okay?
Okay.
Could I do that right now?
Go ahead.
Okay. Today, our people poll is going to be, we're going to be asking people, would you not?
Well, I won't. You're not dead by a long shot. You will be back, as you have said many, many times. But you are recognized as one of the best known radio and television personalities. When did you exactly start in Oklahoma City on television?
I came to Oklahoma City on May 1st, 1950, and I actually started on TV. I did a show backstage at the opera. Reza Stevens came here with Carmen. The Oklahoman brought her to town, and I went backstage at the opera and interviewed all the stagehands.
Great. Well, now that you're doing radio again, let's see, you were doing radio when I was in high school. I remember I drove in the carpool every day, and there was Danny Williams. I remember some
you
of the things
you keep alluding
said.
To my age, Kerry.
I'm sorry.
God, look at me. Do I look like a man 80?
You know, you're looking great. Have you been exercising? Are you 80?
No, I worry a lot. It's what I do. That's, you know, having you back on TV, you're one of the most talented people I've ever been associated with in this business. I'm so happy you're on Channel 9. They're so lucky. They're so smart. Thanks for having us on.
Thank you, Danny, and thank you for passing it on.
God bless you.
Bye. I love you. Still ahead on the Morning Edition, a leading break for the 89ers. We'll have more on that in just a moment. The 89ers love those Niners, continue their league-leading style as they knocked past Denver last night. John Snyder has the details.
The 89ers have led the American Association Western Division since day one of the season back in April, but Denver has always been lurking in the background, four or five games behind. Going into the game...
Just out to our west, some heavier showers out near Elk City. And for the most part this afternoon, we're looking for a chance of rain, and highs will be mainly in the upper 80s to lower 90s. If you're heading out to the ballpark tonight, like I'm thinking about doing, you may want to bring your umbrella.
And a raincoat. In Anadarko this week is one of celebration for Native Americans from 14 tribes. Newsline 9's Gan Matthew tells us the American Indian Exposition is helping preserve a very special heritage.
There's nothing more American than a downtown parade. This year's special guest of honor is country and western singer Crystal Gayle, herself a Cherokee. The Grammy Award-winning Gayle is being honored as the Outstanding Indian of 1985.
Each year, the board of directors, who consists of the 14 tribes, select one person that we feel that has contributed to the...
When we come back, a look at how a special exchange program is providing students from Oklahoma and France with a new window on the world. Stay with us. Good morning again. Welcome to the Morning Edition. It's about 6:51. With us this morning are some people who are helping share our country, our state, and family life with a foreign exchange.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Sissy, before I forget, we have mutual friends, the McCalebs.
That's right.
In Edmond, Oklahoma.
That's right.
That's where I met you a long time ago. Well, tell us exactly what the name of this program is. It's the NACEL Cultural Exchange.
Right.
What is that?
Okay, it's an organization that sends French students to America to study, well, to study and to stay with host families, and also sends Americans to France for the same reason.
And you are the, as the coordinator, then you get the list of the French students and the American students?
Right, I have to find students to go to France and also find 60 host families here in Oklahoma.
Wow, is it difficult to find 60? Looking into the NACEL Cultural Exchange, what phone number would they call?
329-8537.
329-8537.
Right.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, Sissy, you are one of the people or one of the families that volunteered to have a French student come over here. Now, your daughter, I understand, went over...
Well, Kim has studied French for 4 years, and we knew about NACEL because we hosted a student last summer. And when the opportunity came for her to go this summer, we were very anxious for her to take part in the program because we feel like it's a very well-run, very experienced program. So she left for France the end of June and was gone for a month, stayed with us.
And it really is going to be a wonderful experience for you, Colleen. Thank you very much. The phone number again?
329-8537.
Okay, for those people who might be interested in participating in the NACEL Cultural Exchange. Colleen, Sissy, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
We'll be back in just a moment with more Morning Edition. Stay tuned.
Minus our producer Dana Smotherman and Pat Turner, they didn't get to get it out. They didn't get to get out and get their picture taken.
Somebody had to take the picture, I guess.
We want a
dirty job, but somebody had to do it.
You got me all. I'm all.
Oh, and there they are.
And we want to give you something else too. We've got a cookie here.
Oh no!
All right. There we go. Can we get a look at that?
Oh my goodness!
See, a lot of people they're not real familiar.
Share their experiences with you.
And Robbie Merrick with Associated Milk Producers will be my guest. And, of course, you'll have a delicious recipe made with Oklahoma dairy products. We need a little wheat this morning, a little cheese tomorrow.
Good, okay.
Maybe you should have a banker on, Gene, and test some of their stuff, a banker.
Their dough.
A banker?
Yeah.
A baker?
A banker.
Banker?
Yeah.
Oh, dough.
I'm sorry.
Got it.
A little slow.
That one was a little iffy there. Okay, what about the weather? Can you be a little more specific?
We can be a lot more specific. We have a lot of rain, especially in west and northwestern parts of the state. Let's go to the radar, and we'll find the heavy rains right now are moving into Dewey.
It'll be hot.
Not as hot as it has been, though. Special thanks to our guests, Sheila Alexander, Danny Williams, Colleen Wallenbrock, and Sissy Tubb. We hope you can join us tomorrow. It's been a great day. Have a good one. Now stay tuned for CBS Morning News.
Bye-bye.
Gene Wheatley's wardrobe furnished by O'Kane's Big and Tall.